Welcome back to Celeb Memorial TV. Here, we celebrate the legacies of stars who shone brightly in our lives. Join us as we honor their journeys and the lasting impact they made. Before we start, to support us, please hit that like button. Thank you. Marc Gilpin, an American actor remembered for his childhood roles in notable films like Jaws 2, passed away at the age of 56. He succumbed to glioblastoma, a form of brain cancer, in Dallas, surrounded by those who cherished him. Born on September 26, 1966, to Wes Gilpin and Barbara Bushway, Marc grew up in a family rich in love and creativity, alongside his three sisters, April, Patty, and Perry Gilpin. His acting career began early and brought him into the limelight when he portrayed Sean Brody in the 1978 thriller Jaws 2, directed by Jeannot Swark. This role saw him act alongside Roy Scheider and Lorraine Gary, marking a significant early milestone in his career. Marc's ability to capture the essence of his characters shone through in every role he undertook. Beyond the shark-infested waters of Jaws 2, he appeared in Where's Willie in 1978 and Earthbound in 1981, showcasing his versatility across different genres. His performance in The Legend of the Lone Ranger further solidified his place in the entertainment industry during his active years. Though his career on screen was brief, the roles he played left a lasting impression on audiences, especially those who have a fond nostalgia for the films of the late 1970s and early 1980s. Marc's journey through Hollywood, though marked by its early peak and subsequent private life, remained a testament to his skills and the impact one can have regardless of the number of screens they light up. As we remember Marc Gilpin, we not only reflect on his contributions to film, but also on the spirited, vibrant individual he was off-screen. His battle with glioblastoma demonstrated his courage and strength, traits that endeared him to all who knew him personally and admired him from afar. His legacy in the film industry, though rooted in his youthful roles, will continue to be celebrated by those who appreciate the art of classic cinema and the talent that Marc so generously shared with the world. Paul Rubens, the inventive comedian and actor best known for creating the iconic character Pee-wee Herman, passed away at the age of 70. Rubens died at Cedars-Sinai Medical Center in Los Angeles, leaving behind a legacy filled with laughter, creativity, and a unique brand of humor that transcended generations. Born in Peekskill, New York, on August 27, 1952, Rubens was raised in a vibrant family that nurtured his early interests in entertainment. His breakthrough came with the character Pee-wee Herman, developed during his time with the improvisational group The Groundlings in Los Angeles. Pee-wee Herman became a cultural phenomenon in the 1980s, starting with the stage show The Pee-wee Herman Show in 1981 and followed by the blockbuster movie Pee-wee's Big Adventure in 1985, directed by Tim Burton. Rubens's portrayal of Pee-wee Herman was groundbreaking, blending childlike wonder with sophisticated comedy. This character earned a permanent place in the hearts of both children and adults, further cemented by the CBS Saturday morning children's program Pee-wee's Playhouse, which aired from 1986 to 1990. The show was celebrated for its imaginative setting and won 15 Emmy Awards, showcasing Rubens's genius in children's entertainment. Despite facing personal challenges and controversies, Rubens demonstrated resilience, making notable comebacks with appearances in popular TV shows and movies, including 30 Rock, Portlandia, and the Netflix original film Pee-wee's Big Holiday in 2016. He continually embraced his role as Pee-wee with enthusiasm and grace, participating in interviews and revivals that reminded fans of his boundless creativity. Beyond entertainment, Rubens contributed to various charitable causes and remained a beloved figure in the entertainment industry, admired for his dedication to his craft and his ability to bring joy and laughter to audiences around the world. His influence extended beyond film and television, touching the lives of many with his distinctive voice and enduring character. Paul Rubens's death marks the end of an era for a man who was not just a talented actor and comedian, but an indelible part of American pop culture. His legacy as Pee-wee Herman will continue to be celebrated, cherished, and loved by those who remember him not only for the laughter he brought into their lives, but for his heart and imagination that inspired a generation of viewers to embrace their uniqueness. Terrence Beeser, the seasoned character and voice actor recognized for his roles in films like Walk Hard, The Dewey Cox Story, and The Gods Must Be Crazy, as well as television series including The Middle and Raising Hope, passed away at the age of 89. He died at his home in Santa Monica, with his wife of over 55 years, actress Muriel Minette, by his side. Born on February 2, 1935 in Omaha, Nebraska, Besor's family relocated to Los Angeles when he was 7. After serving 4 years in the Navy, he honed his craft at the Pasadena Playhouse and later moved to New York at the age of 30. It was there, in 1968, that he met his future wife Muriel, while performing in back-to-back shows at the Equity Library Theater. Besor's career spanned over 4 decades, during which he left an indelible mark on both the big and small screens. His extensive television credits include appearances on classics such as The Incredible Hulk, Cheers, Dynasty, and more contemporary shows like The Office, Parks and Recreation, and Gilmore Girls. His voice was also familiar to many, contributing to several Star Trek series and video games, and he served as an off-screen announcer for numerous projects. Besor and his wife moved to Concord, Massachusetts for 7 years, where they co-directed numerous shows in the greater Boston area. He earned his MFA from Brandeis University in 1976, and subsequently moved to Los Angeles, where he and Minette continued to perform together in various mediums, including television, commercials, and theater. Terrence Besor was not only a talented actor, but also a proud member of the Actors' Equity Association, his first union. In memory of his legacy, his family suggests donations be made to Entertainment Connections, an organization close to his heart. His lifelong dedication to the craft and his support for fellow actors remain an integral part of his enduring legacy. Johnny Wachter, a talented American actor known for his roles on the series General Hospital in Siberia, tragically passed away at the age of 37. Born on August 31, 1986 in Charleston, South Carolina, Wachter was a charismatic and driven individual from a young age. He excelled academically and athletically at Somerville High School before earning degrees in business administration and Spanish from the College of Charleston. Wachter then moved to Los Angeles to pursue his passion for acting, marking his television debut in Army Wives in 2007. Wachter's career flourished with his portrayal of Brando Corbin on General Hospital from 2020 to 2022, a role that won him acclaim and a devoted fan base. He also shined on Siberia and appeared in notable films such as USS Indianapolis, Men of Courage, and Supercell. His voice could even be heard in the video game Call of Duty, Vanguard. Beyond the screen, Wachter was engaged in life's full spectrum. He had significant relationships, most notably with actress and director Tessa Farrell, and later with actress Caitlin Sullivan. At the time of his untimely death, he was supplementing his acting with bartending, showing his grounded and relatable nature. Wachter's final act of bravery, protecting his co-worker during an attempted theft, epitomized his selflessness and courage, qualities that defined his life as much as his acting skill. His death is not just a loss to the entertainment industry, but to all who knew him or were moved by his performances. His funeral, held on June 16, 2024, at Somerville Baptist Church in his hometown, was a testament to his impact on the lives of many. Johnny Wachter's legacy of kindness, bravery, and artistic spirit will endure, remembered as much for his heroic final act as for his compelling performances. Louis Gossett Jr., an iconic figure in American cinema and television, passed away at the age of 87 at a rehabilitation center in Santa Monica, California. His passing marks the end of a remarkable career that left an indelible impact on the world of entertainment. Born on February 2, 1935 in Brooklyn, New York, Gossett burst onto the acting scene at the tender age of 17. His Broadway debut in Take a Giant Step quickly established him as a formidable talent, setting the stage for a prolific career. He became a beacon of versatility and excellence, with his role in the Broadway hit A Raisin in the Sun further cementing his reputation. Gossett's career reached new heights with his Emmy-winning performance in the groundbreaking miniseries Roots, where he portrayed Fiddler, a character that won hearts with its depth and humanity. This role not only earned him critical acclaim, but also helped propel the conversation about race and history in America. In 1982, Gossett achieved another milestone by winning the Academy Award for Best Supporting Actor for his role as Gunnery Sergeant Emil Foley in an officer and a gentleman, becoming the first African-American actor to win in this category. This role showcased his unique ability to bring tough, compassionate, and complex characters to life, leaving a lasting impression on audiences and critics alike. Throughout his career, Gossett's filmography included an array of diverse roles across film and television, including memorable appearances in Iron Eagle, Enemy Mine, and The Deep. Off-screen, he was known for his activism and philanthropy, particularly in the areas of racial equality and education. Gossett's work extended beyond the screen. He was a vocal advocate for various social issues and used his platform to effect positive change. His dedication to his craft and his commitment to bettering society underscored a legacy not just of entertainment, but of profound influence. As the film and television industry mourns the loss of one of its greatest icons, Louis Gossett Jr.'s legacy will undoubtedly continue to inspire future generations. His body of work and his commitment to equity and justice have left an indelible mark on both the screen and the world at large. Malachi McCourt, a spirited and multifaceted talent, passed away at the age of 92 due to a variety of health issues. Born in Brooklyn in 1931 to Irish immigrants, McCourt's journey from Limerick, Ireland back to the United States shaped a life rich in artistic and personal achievement. McCourt's career spanned acting, writing, and even a foray into politics. As an actor, he graced both the big and small screens with memorable roles in films like The Molly Maguires and Brewster's Millions, and television shows including Another World and All My Children. His distinctive voice and charismatic presence left an indelible mark on each performance. Beyond acting, McCourt was a prolific writer, sharing his vibrant, tumultuous life experiences through several memoirs, including A Monk Swimming and Singing My Hymn Song. His writings provide a vivid panorama of his adventures, misadventures, and the lyrical day-to-day of being part of the Irish diaspora in America. In 2006, McCourt's boundless energy led him into politics, where he ran for governor of New York on the Green Party ticket. His campaign, marked by a blend of humor and serious advocacy for issues like education reform and healthcare, underscored his commitment to influencing society positively. Malachi's legacy is one of passion and perseverance, touching on every facet of human experience from the arts to community activism. He leaves behind a family, a multitude of friends, and countless fans who were moved by his performances, writings, and unwavering dedication to the public good. His life reminds us of the profound impact one individual can have on the fabric of a community. Breaking news. News 1. Jeff Bridges, renowned for his iconic role in The Big Lebowski, shared an uplifting health update and insights into his latest project during the Television Critics Association's summer press tour. Diagnosed with lymphoma in 2020, Bridges revealed he is now in excellent health, which comes as a stark contrast to his condition during the filming of FX's The Old Man. It's bizarre. During the first season, I was performing action scenes while unknowingly having a 9-inch by 12-inch tumor in my stomach, he explained, noting that the tumor remarkably caused him no pain and has since shrunk to the size of a marble. The actor, who is also an accomplished photographer, admitted that he has scaled back on photography since his diagnosis, but remains fully engaged in acting. He quipped about the ease of playing an older character, given his own age, and shared warm stories of working with John Lithgow. Their connection, enriched by their backgrounds as second-generation actors, eschews method acting for a more natural interaction, highlighting a profound camaraderie. Bridges' discussion not only highlighted his resilience, but also his enduring commitment to his craft, despite significant health challenges. His story is not just one of recovery, but a testament to living passionately, underscored by his humorous and heartfelt anecdotes. News 2. Tragedy struck the U.S. Olympic team just days before the start of the 2024 Paris Olympics, as Lulu Connor, the 26-year-old sister-in-law of U.S. water polo captain Maggie Steffens, passed away due to a medical emergency. Connor had traveled to Paris to support Steffens in her quest for a fourth gold medal. Steffens, visibly shaken, shared with the Associated Press, "It's a nightmare, and it's completely shocking. But feeling her spirit here is amazing. I hope that we can make her proud every single day." Connor was not only an ardent supporter, but also an artist and a University of California, Davis graduate. Before her untimely death, she crafted unique clock necklaces for the water polo team members, and even made a special piece for the team's official hype man, rapper Flava Flav. Flava Flav expressed his homage on social media, stating he would wear the clock made by Connor throughout the Olympics, signifying her enduring spirit at the Games. Amidst this personal loss, Stephens led her team to a decisive 15-6 victory over Greece, showcasing resilience and dedication. "It definitely helps to play," Stephens reflected. "I'm trying to embody her spirit, giving 150% to everything, just as Lulu did."